Here we are. Yes, sounds good. Well, we are honored that you are here with us, sir. You know, but this means that you have time to do interviews now. So instead of attending White House coronavirus briefings like we've gotten so used to seeing you do. So tell us, when was the last time you actually spoke with President Trump?
Not last week, but the week before.
Okay.
I spoke with him when we made the presentation to explain to him our vaccine development efforts. So it was two weeks ago. Yeah.
Now, according to the Washington Post, Dr. Fauci, 21 states saw an increase in their average daily new coronavirus cases last week. Do you think that states reopened too soon?
You know, I think it's tough to make broad statements. I think that there certainly were states that did not strictly follow the guidelines that we put out about opening America again. You know, there were rather well delineated gateway criteria followed by phase one, phase two, and phase three. And clearly there were states who left to their own decision about that, went ahead and opened to a varying degree, maybe even, I wouldn't say too soon, but certainly before they got to the benchmarks that they needed to get. The other thing that I think is important is that even when states officially go by the standard type of recommendations, you still see people within a state or a city who are essentially not adhering to the kinds of recommendations, particularly in situations of congregating together without wearing a mask. I mean,
yeah,
that clearly is a risky procedure. So a state as a state may be saying, okay, we are in this particular stage of the reopening, but then you might find people within the state who are actually not really adhering to the kinds of structured type of guidelines that belong to the phase that they're in. And that's the thing that's troublesome, because that clearly is increasing the risk and likely explaining some of the upticks that you're seeing in certain of those states.
And what's adding to the questions of whether or not these states have reopened too soon, things like, you know, in Arizona, that state has emerged as one of the newest hotspots. Health experts have explicitly linked the surge to the state's lifting of their stay-at-home orders. Also in Texas, reported recently 4 days, I believe, of just a spike in hospitalizations. Now, Dr. Fauci, one listener wrote to us on Facebook, and they said, how do we get our local leaders to follow the advice of public health officials like you? When our highest leaders disregard public health suggestions, why would the rest of the U.S. do it?
Well, you know, obviously that's a difficult question to answer. The only thing we try and do, and one of the reasons why I always enthusiastically speak, you know, with you and your colleagues, is that we need to keep getting home the message. I think an important message that sometimes gets confused and conflated with what we're trying to say is that one can proceed. It isn't all or none. The thing that gets confusing, it isn't as if you stay locked down or you just open up and leave caution to the wind. You can proceed towards the normalization in a way at the same time that you carefully adhere to certain of the types of guidelines which tell you to not do things that are at risk. For example, you can proceed and get a degree of economic recovery, a degree of back to being employed, at the same time that you do some fundamental things like avoiding crowds, like wearing a mask, like washing your hands. So it isn't all or none. And the thing that is disconcerting to public health people and scientists and physicians like myself is that when you take a look at what's going on out there, you see that it's either all or none. They're either people really, really careful,
yeah,
or many people say, well, if I'm not going to be locked down, then I'm just not going to have any restrictions. We should let the public health component help us to safely reopen. It isn't all or none. It isn't black and white. And that's the reason why when you do see crowds that are gathering together in a way that is almost asking for trouble, particularly when you're not wearing masks, that increases the risk.
Well, let me put it to you this way before we take a pause. To what extent do you feel like local and national leaders are to blame for these surges?
You know, I don't want to be blaming people. That's not helpful. I think what we really need to do is to say, these are the facts. We know that when you have mitigation of the types we're talking about, avoiding crowds, wearing masks, that clearly has a positive effect. So when you pull away from that and you still have viral dynamics in your community, that's not a good idea. So rather than blame one or the other, just listen to what I'm saying. It's risky when you do that, so please avoid doing that.
Listen to the doctor. Very good advice. We are talking to Dr. Anthony Fauci, the director of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases at the National Institutes of Health.